52 kilogram flyweight competition are: number 1, Kazakhstan; 2, Poland; 3, Argentina; 4, People's Republic of China; and 5, Republic of Korea. The referee is Bouadir Jumani Yazov from Uzbekistan.
Thanks for that, Dan. Okay, XL London, it's time. Let's hear some noise. Are you ready for the boxers? Then let's bring out the welterweights.
Representing the United States of America, last year's World Championship bronze medalist, Rauche Warren. And in the blue corner, representing France, Nourine Obali. Comes out. Round one.
Well, the touch of gloves is a significant moment in the history of American Olympic boxing. The following round, Royce Warren competes in his third Olympic Games. The first was a light fly, the last 4 years ago as a fly, and he was in 2012. So congratulations to him, but enough of congratulations. He's got to overcome having had a bye in his opening contest. He's got to overcome a new experience, and also 25 in his second Olympic Games as a former world bronze medalist from 2007. Light fly, the year that Rauche Warren was the world champion.
Well, Obali just made a rare mistake there, the way he went in quite quick the feet, but he walked onto a shot. But this Frenchman is very good at delivering combinations, and that's what he'll try to do, move those feet into range and deliver three or four shots. I've been impressed with him in his first contest. I've seen him a couple of times in other tournaments as well. Warren's more experienced, he's older, and he's very dangerous. Got a lot of power, this American, and he's got a target catching Obali as he's coming forward.
Disappointment of Beijing 4 years ago when he lost his opening contest in Lee from Korea by 9 points to 8. Warren has come back and he's bouncing back here, and he really needs to do something because the state of American amateur boxing, particularly and most importantly at Olympic level, is not very healthy at all. Whatever's gone wrong, we can't put a finger on it, but it doesn't seem to be working for them. I was just mentioning 4 years ago that Warren lost 9-8 to the Korean Lee, and he thought he had the contest won. He ran for the last minute of the round, not realizing he was a point behind. And that was up on the scoreboard in the days when everybody could see the scoreboard clearly. So a tactical error for Warren cost him the chance of an Olympic medal. And here he's back aiming for another one.
Yeah, the more dangerous punches are definitely coming from the man in red with that right hook. He just drops that hand has to lure his opponent in and draw his opponent onto his shots. But Ubali has got to keep his left hand a little bit higher, Jim, as he's coming forward, because he's walking onto this vicious left hook. I know it wasn't a bad left hand, sorry, vicious right hook, should I say, from the American.
Having a little bit of a problem with his headgear, Raishi Mark. Good sort of stabbing right hand by the Frenchman, and good covering up, just eased himself away from the onrushing American. Good footwork by Warren. Great little man on the back foot. A lot of neutrals would really love to see him win the elusive Olympic medal that they probably feel he may well deserve, but there's no sentiment in sport, particularly at Olympic level. You take your chance. This fellow in blue will have something to say about that.
Just walks onto another shot there, Ubali. Just making mistakes as he's coming forward. He's coming through those straight lines, so he's got to just vary his angle of attack sometimes. A little sidestep here and there. That's a little bit better from both of them.
Good single shot from Warren before that last right hand. Left him deflected. Left him very busy round. Score going a huge attack.
Just about everything
deserved. It took a few, but gave a few.
Yeah, can't disagree with the score. The American is just ahead, catching his opponent there with a super left hand and then right hook. And that really sent Ubali going backwards. I think he was hurt a couple of times in this round by the American. That's a sweeping right hook straight at the chin there by Warren. Just had the better of things, and yet Ubali comes back with a straight 1-2 in that sequence there.
Right.
Not
like it. Catching him coming forward.
Better defense.
Round 2. Both American coaches talking to Rashi Ron, which I think is maybe a bit confusing. One says captain coming forward, the other says better defense. So 9-6 up. A little fellow in all red, Rashi Ron from the United States. Three-time Olympian, which is a huge achievement. The medal that he really would love to get is still somewhere else. He needs to win this one, and he needs to win another one before he's into the medals. And I don't think Ubali is going to let him take that particular step with great ease. Didn't do desperately well in the Olympics 4 years ago. He lost to the beaters from Uzbekistan. And then lost 3-3, if you recall, that G2 Zhu Xinling. And that went to count back, and the French team and the French corner were distraught because they thought their man had done enough to win against the then reigning world champion and the best light flyweight in the world at the time.
Ubali is very busy, Jim, but what he's got to do when he steps up at close range, he's got to throw more combinations, and he's got to switch the attack, body to head. Maybe start off with a feint to the head, rip downstairs with two or three shots, and then return fire again to the head, ending on probably on the right hook. Remember, an odd numbered combination is always the better option because it closes the guard up quicker than an even number.
Explain that to me, Richard.
Well, if you start off a combination, especially with the lead hand, an odd numbered combination of three or five is a better combination because it closes the guard up of the attacking boxer quicker. An even number, then he's finishing on with the rear hand, which for a split second takes longer to get back to the on guard target area, you say. So odd numbered combinations in this situation most definitely would be the better option.
As always, for all matters technical, I'm in your debt, Richard. Midway through the second, 9-6 to the American, Raishi Warren at the start of this one. And although Ubali is getting into punching range, he's not landing with the punches. The feet are fine, the fists aren't. That was a slip.
That's why 1-2 right hook here for Ubali would work a treat, but he's got to get close enough to do that.
Warren holding on, using all that experience, three world championships he's boxed in. He's got a couple of bronze medals. He's got a gold medal from Chicago 2007.
Warren is much better at mid and long range. His strength is definitely at mid range, but when he allows his Frenchman in on the inside, that's when he's vulnerable. but that's when the Frenchman must work harder.
There's a good left hand from the ballet. Warren's feet were far too flat and far too slow, and he did get caught. He's only 25 on the first floor, but he got his first Olympics at 17. And the ballet's got him again. Warren's dreams are a little bit muddled. He missed the third attempt. Just keep slipping away. There's nothing left in it between them. 9-6, they won the opening round. And Bally's come back and has picked them off here and there. Warren needs to do a little bit more, remember. Sometimes he has a lack of concentration. And that's cost him. Let's see what the score says. Well, there's only a point between them. It was a much better round, as we suspected, for Morgan Bally from France. Rousey won,
got to understand this.
You've
got to understand.
Really,
this guy is punching everywhere. Look at me. Look at me, son.
I need you to do that.
We got to punch off the break. We can't let him tie us up. We got to be a little bit more aggressive. We're not aggressive enough. We're going away.
I agree with you, Mace. I'm going to tie you up. Both getting caught for shots here, but the Frenchman definitely works harder in this round. It's a great exchange there. What a super right up to the body that was from Warren. Then he switches upstairs, which doesn't get through. But Bali worked much harder here in this round. It's a little left up on the inside there from him. That was a cracking punch. This guy's had a work harder.
Come on, son. Listen.
Second foul.
We got to close this show right now.
Round three.
In Olympic terms, the two most experienced men in this highly competitive division. Three-time Olympian Rousey Warren in red. And his opponent from France, Nourdine Obali. And this is his second Olympic Games. Please.
Obali straight on the front foot again.
Good shot by Obali. Cracking right hand. Is that going to bring a count? The referee's having a good look at Warren. I think his headgear needs to be adjusted. Please.
Well, Obali's really going for it now. He's got to create that gap though. Look, he works better on the inside. Warren's timing is gone completely. He's got to start being more accurate as Obali's coming to him.
Desperate times now for Rousey Warren. Nourdine Obali has been on his case all the way through. This is a torrid time now for the American, who had serious hopes that this is third Olympics on a first Olympic medal. Into the second minute. Anything, Richie, I think the Frenchman might just have nudged ahead.
Yeah, Warren's just waiting a little bit too long now, isn't he? He's waiting for his man to come in, but his accuracy tonight has just left him, especially in this last round. The Frenchman, the urgency's there from him. Keeps coming forward, forcing the issue. He's action-packed with Warren.
Well, we thought last year in the World Championships and Warren qualified, having got to the semi-finals. Quarters that he was back to form. It suddenly deserted him in the second round. He's got to pick it up here in the second half of this third and last round if it's not going to be another pretty miserable Olympics for the American boxing team.
And Warren chose to sit on the back foot and wait for the ball in all the contest. Now let's see him go forward, let's see him put the Frenchman under pressure.
Warren's going to get told off for not facing his opponent at all times. And a bit of shoving as well. To 1 minute to go. Warren needs to do something a bit more. If he wants to win this, he has to step forward.
He's landing those big shots. Okay, he's looking just off the break there, that right up. He should be using his jab a little bit more, Warren. Just to measure that gap, measure that distance, and as his opponent comes, then let the left hand go. There you go.
And the left from Obali. 45 seconds to go. Is it going to be third time unlucky for Rousey Warren? And that will mean that eight of the American nine strong contingent in the men's boxing tournament here in London 2012 will have gone. They'll be left with just one. Messy last round. Both of them tiring. Warren, remember, his first contest having had a bye. The Frenchman with a win over a useful Afghanistan boxer who's a tripartite. 20 seconds or less remaining. What do you think, Richard?
I think it's literally either way. Someone now needs last 10 seconds or so just to find a quality punch. There is one there, good scoring blow by Obali. He may have done enough.
Last few seconds, Obali comes, gets him with a left hook around the corner. Maybe didn't land quite on the target. And Warren raises the hand. I thought for a moment he was raising the hand of the Frenchman. And the French corner are more than convinced that their man has got it. The scenes in the American corner are certainly less than ecstatic. Warren, I just think, let that one slip. He won the opening round by 9-6. The Frenchman won it 7-5. And I think, well, the Frenchman may have won it this last round. Warren came on reasonably strongly at the end, but the start a little bit of the round. The French, and that was a lovely left hook, turned it over nicely. Clear scoring touch for the judges to see. The judges will have deliberated, and the decent title will be brought. And to read out the answers.
Obali again just did the better work in that last round. He hit the work out of the tempo. The morning went on, one was a little bit ragged, and if I have to go either way, I think the blue corner, one, maybe 2 points at the very most, but I think he's got it.
He reckons he's got it. Warren is hoping he's got it. I'm not sure he did enough. We shall see.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 19 points to 18 in the blue corner, representing France, Nordin Agoule.
Obali has got it. 19-18. He won the last round by 16 points before 7-5 is second round.
And your appreciation also, please, for Roushi Warren, representing the United States of America.
So all the hopes of the American boxing side that Roushi Warren would get a medal of some kind, and this is 30 Olympic Games have gone. The 9 strong American team have gone to 1 single boxer, because Roushi Warren, one of the favourites for a medal, has been beaten by this fellow, Nordin Agoule, from France. Disappointment. Disappointment indeed. And he knows it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges for the second bout in the men's 52 kilogram flyweight division are number 1, Hungary. Number 2, Canada. 3, Cuba. 4, Philippines. And 5, Algeria. The referee is Vladislav Malashev from the Russian Federation. The boxers come to us from Ghana and Ireland, so please welcome them as they make their way to the arena. Seconds out. Round one.
Two 21-year-olds coming together in this 52-kilogram contest. The taller of the two in red is the Ghanaian Duke Micah, who is a couple of months older than his opponent, in blue representing Ireland, the boy from Belfast, Michael Conlon, came through by virtue of a quarter-final finish in the World Championship last year, lost by one single point to Andrew Selby of England. 25-24. Conlon, the taller of the two, both those are doctors. Good, solid looking now. Watch the head from the referee to Micah, who qualified as the fourth out of six possible qualifiers in the African tournament.
He's waited a long time with Conlon, and I've been hugely impressed with him when he's come over with the Irish team to spar the Team GB. Very talented boy indeed, and I think he's the dark horse in the division. Just got to shake off a few cobwebs here, having waited so long. But as a switch hitter also, look, switching from orthodox to southpaw. Good balance, good technique. And he's just wants to get this win out of the way. But yeah, just literally telling the duties again there that he scored with the right hand. You can see it was a good shot.
Some boxers like to do that when they feel they've landed. They took the hand up in the air just to say, hey, that was me landed with that. Midway through this first round, Conlon just starting to warm up a little bit. And as you said, Richie, he's had to shake off the cobwebs, and he's had to weigh every day, and he's had to make sure he's got the weight right, because you have to not just weigh in on the opening day before the draw is made. You've got to weigh in on the day of the contest itself. And you can't afford to say, I wouldn't mind that extra sausage at breakfast time. A good shot by Conlon, but it was well blocked by Duke Micah. He was pretty impressive in his opening contest against the Vigilante from Mauritius. A swing by Conlon, still not just quite getting into the groove, so to speak. That was a better right hand. He shortened the punch and came round the corner.
Yeah, Micah should be setting the tempo a little bit better in here, Jim, because he's got that advantage of having that one contest under his belt. The boxer just probably coming into the tournament, having the first contest at this stage. He's never going to be at his best. There's a few nerves. He's got to get back into the pace of things. And so Micah is just waiting too long. I think he's struggling with the movement of Conlon. He's got to cut that ring space off a little bit better, but he's not doing it.
And his corner might just be a bit concerned, Richie, that Conlon is falling short with a lot of his lead shots.
Yeah, the problem he's got, Jim, he's just too far away from his opponent at this stage. What he's got to do is work more with his jab. His leading leg is the range-finding leg. It's got to be assisted with that left jab. Just to measure the gap and then get your feet into range. He's just out of range slightly. And that's because he's waited so long to box.
Good shot by Conlon right at the end of the round. And I don't think it's going to be very much in it. But the Irishman's got a 5-12 to two. And we need a generous team.
No, I don't think it was.
Round two.
First round out of his way after almost a week of waiting, and one would like to think that he's warmed up a little bit more. Now. Good right hand by Connor. That's exactly what the corner told him to do. Get that right hand round the corner, because his opponent in red from Ghana, Duke Micah, drops that left of his.
Yeah, movement is the key here for Conlon. Measuring with the jab, like I said, the movement is crucial. Once he stops his feet and holds his feet, then that gives Micah a chance to launch an attack. So movement, hit and move for Conlon is what he's got to do. Micah is struggling with the movement, but then he does have a chance to work on the inside. It's Conlon is presenting the opportunity now again. He should fight for combinations to go there, especially downstairs. Slow down the movement action.
There's another round the corner, right hand, it's a bit of an overhead sweeping, almost haymaker-like punch, but it's landing midway through the second. Conlon was 5-2 up at the start of this, there's a slip, feet got entangled, Conlon came out of it nicely. Oh, good shot, Kuracking straight left. Covers up well and moves well out of danger.
That was lovely skill, wasn't it? He hit the target and then he laid back. Forcing laid back on the ropes, but nevertheless hit the target and moved, didn't get hit. That's where he doesn't need to be, and he knows it. Look, comes back into centre, clever boy.
Be interesting to see how they review the seeding scenario after these Olympic games. The first time we've had seeding, a lot of the seeds are given byes, and they probably don't want byes. It's quite nice to be separated. You don't want the number two seed and the number one seed, or the two top boxers in the world meeting, as used to be the case because of the luck of the draw. But certainly the seeds, if they're given buys, they would think, well, listen, I don't get the box for a week.
So you don't want to buy in this tournament. No way, you're going to be up and running as soon as you can. These lads are fit enough to box 5-6 times in a couple of weeks. No problem at all.
Same in the World Championship, how do you actually do that? Yeah. 30 seconds remaining, Conlon 5-2 up. The tall Belfast boy in blue. Great tradition in Irish American Olympic boxing from boxers from Belfast and Ireland. 12 Olympic boxing medals, no fewer than 7 have been won by little tough guys from Belfast.
Micah hasn't quite got the quality of punch. He's got opportunities there to land more shots, but just cannot find the target. He's not throwing enough of them. He must work harder, Micah, if he's going to have any chance. But Conlon, well, way ahead now.
Micah slowing down and Conlon catching him on the retreat. There's another good one for the Irishman. A better one this time. Clear winner of that one. 7-3 to Conlon. Back to the 5-2 in the fourth time.
Simple stuff. Every time he has a step back from him, he's falling in. Either meet him in a right hand or a one thing.
Jab. Is it going to beat him? All step up in meeting. Why are you doing this?
You are playing your jumping and what are you jumping
in? Combination here, left up to the body with superb, moving the head. His balance has got to be a little bit better, but nevertheless, he's finding the target and he's moving away. A little bit wild in the shots there, really good action shots to the show. And there's that right hand from Conlon. Super punch, then he moves back into that limited distance out of punching range. Change of foot there, that was excellent for him. And straight left hand. That was a bit of class.
Okay.
Round 3.
A comfortable lead. 12 points to 5 enjoyed by the man in blue in this last round. And this 52-kilogram division came last year in the Olympic Games in London 2012. The man in blue is the boy from the St John Bosco Club in Belfast, where he's coached by John Conlon. His dad. Duke Micah had a reasonably efficient opening run, but lost a lot of ground in the second as he got caught with shots like that. And Micah, I think, Richie, will just have to come storming forward. And that wasn't a bad left hand by the man. Conlon needs to watch himself in the ropes. I don't know whether Micah's got a single concussive punch or not, but he's going to try to find one somewhere. And he'll have to do it. Conlon has to be nice and measured and nice and controlled. Oh, wonderful work on the back foot by Conlon, snaked out that left hand again. And because Micah is now throwing everything into this, he's leaving himself open for counter shots.
Well, he's overcommitting, he still hasn't got that accuracy sorted out as Micah, so he's leaving himself open. But it's better from the guardrail on the front foot. Unfortunately for him, he's doing it in the wrong areas of the ring. He's doing it from centre, now he should be trying to push his man back to the ropes to restrict that movement. The movement is the key for Conlon. but Mike is very strong. He cannot nail him because his feet are too slow. He's very flat-footed.
Again, Conlon finds the escape route, and then he picks his man up. And that was a lovely stabbing left. Just showed it to him and then delivered it. Conlon are looking a little bit more confident. First time he's done anything resembling showboating. And his stance has changed completely, Richie. He's not upright. He's not the classical orthodox boxer. He's now just relaxed a little bit.
Well, this is not a bad performance from Conlon in his first bout at the tournament, because he won't be feeling at his best. He'll feel much better as the tournament goes on if he wins this contest. But Micah just can't nail him because mainly his feet are very flat. He can't move at speed. Big scrappy there. He's got to try and push Conlon back and corner him or get him on the ropes. Conlon clever, the boxing from the centre.
And he's supporting the XL arena being pretty vociferous, as you'd expect. Here comes Conlon again. Micah tiring, has to hold on. He's got Conlon's arm under his own. Referee's let that go. Conlon, good covering up by the Ghanaian. Conlon.
He switches a southpaw there, Conlon. We'll have to watch that because you're more open to a right hand and left hook combination from that stance. But nevertheless, very confident, maintaining the gap all the time is Conlon. His movements, oh, that was a super shot with the left hand, super punch.
Low hands, but fast feet. Good combination, Conlon moving. Covering up when he has to, into the final 30 seconds of this, the third and last round. And having shaken off the ring rust and having waited for a week, it looks very much as if Michael Conlon, the Irish 52-kilogram boxer, is going to progress to the point where he's one more contest away from an Olympic boxing medal for Ireland. Last few seconds, Conlon just standing. Micah can do nothing with him. Conlon tips him again as he moves away. Another clear scoring shot. And this has been a good last round by Michael Conlon. And until he shows one this by a distance. And keep Michael nice fair than he is, knows it and gives him a hug.
Good performance for the first contest of the Olympic Games. Sit back those mirrors, those cobwebs. Be a bottom of pressure. See you tomorrow. He's got the truth of hit. Good movement too from him. Bringing his opponent up to shots and then he's away with that layback. Back to the centre of the ring. Hitting and moving. He's got the stones all about. Hit and don't get hit. Super straight right hand punch there. And then moves out around again. There's a safe ball there. And there's that shot. That was the best punch of the round. A short left uppercut in that corner. Great punch. That was belter. Lovely technique. Head a little bit low, but just gets out of the way. Good performance.
Are we going to get
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 19-8 in the blue corner, representing Ireland, Michael Conlon.
It's Conlon. 19-8 and a 7-3 line. 5-2 the first, 7-3 the second.
And please show your appreciation for Duke Nika representing
Michael
Ghana.
The number 6 seed here in the 52 kilogram division in the boxing tournament number 25 has come through with a wee bit of style. Harder contest to come, but he has won more victory away from the Olympic medal. The Irish will be very pleased with Michael Conlon. This fellow did very well, only 21 years of age. I think he'll be around for a year or two, but likewise, Michael Conlon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges for the third round of the men's 52 kilogram flyweight division are number 1 Lithuania, 2 Germany, 3 Sweden, 4 Ecuador, and 5 India. The referee is Michael Gallagher from Ireland. This is Ireland's Thailand versus Cuba, and here come the boxers.
Yeah.
Economical, isn't he, this Cuban? Doesn't waste a lot. Works well, basics with the jab, and also straight left and right up. The punches that he throws a lot of. But yeah, I like his style, his movement as well. He gets close, there you go, just slips downstairs there, that left hand to the body, switches the attack with the right up to the head. And all, well, you know, Jim, I don't know whether Cuban's good, but this fella is no different.
Started slowly in his opening contest and kept that head down, kept a very tight guard, and then all of a sudden he just moved into cruise control and pulled away from the Japanese boxer very comfortably. And the whole Cuban squad, they had their preparation, their final preparation, over in Northern Ireland, boxing at the King's University gym there. For being the outstanding hurler. I don't know if hurling will catch on in Cuba, but welcome to everybody in Northern Ireland who hosted them, and the Argentinians and the Ecuadorians and the Brazilians.
I'll tell you what, this he's putting in a good display in this opening round. Intimidated by Ramirez, working well. And what I like about Ramirez also, Jimmy, how he adjusts his feet. He just maintains the gap between himself. Lovely jab. I mean, just through the guard there. And as his opponent comes forward, he adjusts the feet just to create that gap so he can work again.
And of course, self-caught with a very good right hand from Bouts, who lost his opening contest in the World Championship. Oh, what a great shot. What a great shot from nowhere.
And it ain't work again. Left hand, short, very short punch there.
Fuck. I think Michael Gallagher, you know, was just closing the card there because Ramirez had gone back directly into the neutral corner. But that's a good start, that's a good left into the body from this teenager from Cuba. Economical, lazy, languorous style. Good right hand once again from Bouts. But Ramirez was on the retreat and he soaks it all up in the gloves. Very good opening round of boxing. Not much between them. Despite that standing out count, there's only two between them. But it's in favour of this one. And Cuba 6-4 he leads.
Yeah, good score. Some good work from Bouts here. There's a good straight right hand and then he gets back to safety. He is in and out. There's that left hand. That was a fantastic combination there. In, out, and then back in again with straight one, two. Short, sharp left hand. Lovely punch.
Yeah, but he just off balance, and the off balance was a good shot.
Round two.
Three boxers. And then the next two. two, and he's quite happy to mix it up. There's a wee grin in his face, and he looks over his corner and nods as if to say, yeah, I don't know what way I take this fellow on. But Butti will want to try to close him down and get in with solid body shots, which he certainly tried to do.
Excellent work. The quality of punching is better from the Cuban. It's a little bit sharper, delivered with better technique. That's the difference. What Bouts has got to do here, he's got to sustain a little bit more pressure. He's allowing Ramirez to work on the outside, in and out. So maybe double up the attack from the Thai boxer, or even sustain the pressure, put him on his back foot and keep the work going. Don't let him go in and out. This Cuban, if you look at this Cuban, Jim, he doesn't move out of range very far. He's in with a step of moving back into punching range as he comes out.
And the fact he doesn't step back too far will encourage the opponent to come to him.
Exactly.
Bouts trying to bear, what a good stiff, classic right hand.
His judgment of distance and timing, the Cuban, is spot on.
Enjoying himself now. Exactly the same as we saw in his opening contest against Souza from Japan. Had a lot of foot movement in his opening round. Well blocked. Well blocked. Was hit with the open part of the glove anyway, according to the US referee. Nothing in the middle. A bit deep, but he's really hard to get through. He's not going to get through the straight leg. He's got to work out how to get on the back of his elbows.
Couple of his counters as well, but Ramirez, he's thrown plenty of jabs, he's given him opportunities to come back with counters, but this Thai boxer isn't quick enough. He's standing too far away also to launch an attack. A bit flat-footed, looking at his back heel on the floor.
Just got the feeling that Ramirez is cruising at the moment. Kind of a waiting game.
One more mistake that the Cuban's got, when he goes back, they're only going to bring his feet together. So he likes to box in and out, and he brings those feet together. That's a slight fault. A good boxer, international level, spots that, but he'll have to pounce on him. He's on his feet together, he's slightly off balance. But I'm just nitpicking here, to be honest.
I suppose that you have time to nip down and tell the tight corner that it would rather stay here.
I'm just nitpicking, really, and there's not a lot wrong with his style, but
he's shot by Bouts. Seconds to go to the end of the second, another decent round for the man in blue. Led 6-4 at the start of the fight, wouldn't be surprised if the gap stretched. And he has been set at 8-3, he won that second round. 14-7, he needs an uplift to lead, but an unsustainable lead. And we're going to show this fellow.
Safety again. Boxing well within himself. His distance, his timing is superb. Really got caught in the shot there. Delivered that first punch. Watch him adjust the feet. Adjusts the feet and then brings the opponent onto into shots. Doesn't drift too far away from his opponent. Always within half a step. Back into punching range. Poking and prodding. Gets caught there. That was a little bit better from Bouts.
Second hour.
Against this man. So, there's a huge task ahead for Chacha Bouts, the 27-year-old in red from Thailand. He's just 9 years older than his opponent, the 18-year-old, the youngest member of the Cuban side, the overseer Ramirez Calazana. He's looking pretty comfortable, starting slowly, picked up the pace. He took his man off with clever single forces. Bouts had taken one or two, doesn't seem to bother him too much. But it's the final score that counts, and if he keeps going like this now, the final score should be in his favour. Back to the way he was at the start of the contest, just soaking things up in the gloves. Very confident in his own strength and fitness, obviously. And the left hand in the middle wasn't too far away from him. Illegal. That was a lovely hook once again. He does so much wonderful work.
He's got great balance, the Cuban. When he's actually punching, brilliant balance, and then gets back on the outside. Yeah, he's literally taking his foot off the gas here. He's probably saving himself a little bit. speak to his opponent as well.
Snapped off the right hand. Ramirez got himself caught. Enjoying it now. Knows he's a minute and a half away from victory. Unfortunately for Bouts, he can't put the tempo coming. He was just pinching against the elbows and the arms. Can't find a way through. He needs to feint the attacks more. Make his opponent think there's an attack coming, which isn't, and then get a reaction and then maybe punch off him. But just walk. These are shots now coming from Ramirez. These are hurtful blows.
You sometimes just want to sit back and enjoy.
Just, the technique is tremendous by the Cubans. Quality of punching, look at the head movement there, heavy department, but his adjustment of the feet and creating a gap and the room to work is excellent.
Ramirez had to box six times in the matter of a week or so in Baku and Azerbaijan a couple of years ago to win the World Youth Championship. It was a bantamweight at 54. He is now looking to win the second contest, and I think he's going to win the second contest in the Olympic Games. 52 kilograms is the flyweight division. Just in the last half minute, nothing that Bouts can do. He's been very one-paced all the way through. Against other boxers, that one-paced would have been enough.
Yeah, he's walked onto shots in this round, especially now to the start to a hurtful shot. That was a little bit low. The two or three big punches going in there from Ramirez, and that would tire his opponent even more. This fellow right now is exhausted, he's taken a lot of shots. He's well beaten.
That's another big round for the Cuban. Did exactly what he did in his opening contest against his Japanese opponent. And he just simply ran away with it.
Look at the draw, isn't it, for this guy? Second contest. Yeah, box lovely. Straight hand there. 1-2, right up combination. The first 1-2 that were the best punches there. Just his timing, his rhythm. Oh, lovely. In the left hand. And then he works downstairs as well. That was a bit off target, but yeah, good performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 22 points to 10 in the blue corner representing Cuba, Rabasi Ramirez Carazana. Please show your appreciation for Sakai Bouts representing Thailand.
This fellow from Cuba, 22.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges for the fourth bout in the men's 52-kilogram flyweight division are number 1, Morocco, 2, Turkey, 3, Vietnam, 4, Philippines, 5, Poland. The referee is John S. Kennedy from Brazil. The two boxers come to us from Kazakhstan and Great Britain, so please give them a big hand as they enter the arena.
Judges from Morocco, Turkey, Vietnam, the Philippines, and Poland. Referee is from Brazil. He's become the norm here on the channel. He's gone from the world wide. 14 bronze medals behind him as well.
Switch hitter, that means he'll go from orthodox to southpaw. Look, he's a southpaw now. Sometimes he does it, he doesn't even realise he does it so naturally. And he's one of those rare talents who can box as good as a southpaw as he can as an orthodox. Working round there downstairs. This is not a bad start for him. He's a tricky man here. He's obviously really got a win under his belt. So Salvi's going to sell down, working on his jab. He's bitter with those counters on the back foot. Himself into the contest.
Lively start, good combination there by Selby. His opponent came through again, starting with 2-0 from Sweden, the Tanzanian ground boxer. But Siliminov is not going to go away.
No, the Kazakhs have brought a strong team here. But that's good combination work from Selby. Going threes and fours, he started well. Just got to establish his jab a little bit more and bring his opponent onto shots. When his opponents are coming onto him, he's much better, Selby. Better as a counter-puncher. But he's working well here. Yeah, that's nice.
Nice combination, and then ducks down to avoid any retribution. Good footwork by Selby. Got caught with a little right hand from the Kazakh. Into the third minute of this opening round. Three threes, remember, unlike previous Olympics where it was 4-2. But I think most people are happy. It's back to the old three threes. Siliminov misses. Selby moves. Selby stabs and jabs and picks up another point, I'm sure. Wide stance by Selby, going back to southpaw again.
His movement is important in this contest, as it is in most of the contests that he has, Selby. And he's got to stay off the ropes. He's better from centre. Gets caught with a shot there.
That was a great shot, and yep. The Kazakh put his hand up as if to say to the judges, did you see that? Well, I hope they did for his sake, and I hope for Selby's sake they didn't.
Yeah, I hope they saw that one from Selby as well. Good right hand from Selby as he came in, the Kazakh.
Tough opening round this.
Yeah. Not a lot in this opening round.
Good footwork again by Selby. Gets himself extricated from those little pinches. Finish up with a very good left into the midline. Nice sweet little shot from the British boxer. Well miles from Cardiff to end the run. Snorting and thinking that shot that was good enough. It was just about good enough. The keeper's nose a little 6-5.
Yeah, it was a close round. There's a point either way, to be quite honest, so I'm not going to disagree with the scoring. It's a good combination of punches from Andrew. Yeah, right at the end of the round, he gets caught with a good straight right. But right at the end of the round, he produced a lovely combination.
Quickly, left hand to the body. Right, come on, let's do this. Let's go.
Sharp, ball. Lead right into the face of his opponent, slips the southpaw in a matter of seconds.
Because what's going to happen here is Semenov is going to get a little bit more desperate, rushing in. And he actually will put the shots in. Semenov just going to get his timing right, just wait for his opponent to launch those fast attacks. There's opportunities there to actually score. Semenov complains to the referee there, that was a low blow. Going for the referee.
There's a good left hand went in there from Andrew Selby, who, like so many seeded boxers, have had to miss out on an early start, and they've had to wait, and they've had to wait. And it's taken them a long time to really just get things together. Selby ducking down and holding, referee won't allow that. Gets away from his man, referee doesn't have to call break. Good boxing and good officiating. Selby again back to southpaw, again ducks down. Good chase down the back of the head, I think, to the...
He's not flowing as well as he usually does, and that's because he's waited a long time, but that was excellent from Salva there. He brought his opponent onto those shots, fast combinations, working well on the on the outside, but just showing a few signs of ring rust. But that was and confidence there.
The class is coming through, Richie. Talent, the class is coming through. Salva now is just at the midway stage at this round, and after the midway stage of the contest, he's all of a sudden finding the sort of form that took him to the European title and very nearly won our world championship. Behind that, he would have been there, seeking to his country, following Frankie Gavin to become a world champion. 1 more minute to go. Again, it's going to be a close thing. The right hand from Stilmanov, who's not letting Selby out of his sights at all. And Selby has to be using all that ring craft of his, because this fellow is very strong.
Salvi's put his combinations to better now due together. Well, he's got a concentrate on his counter-attacking. As his opponent starts coming forward, stepping there and beating to the pitch. And he can do that, he's got good timing.
Good shot, and again with the left. Two corking little punches.
You can see a switch there from orthodox to southpaw. Confuses his opponent, and then he just catches his opponent as he's coming in. Lovely work, very skillful indeed, Selby.
In and out again with that right. Good finish by Andrew Selby, and a much better run. I think he's extended the lead to maybe 3 points, if not more. Yep, 4 points, 6-3 to Selby. Huge. Electronic scoreboard above the ring. Times the expected 10,000 here in the XL Arena.
He didn't start the round too well, but as the round went on, he got better and better. Gets caught with a couple of shots here on the road, but then delivers a lovely little left hook. Knows he shouldn't be on the road, so moves off. Brings his opponent on there to a super left hand. Creates that gap again, and then goes back at his opponent. Shouldn't read on those ropes. but there just replies with a left hand, then he moves off the ropes. That's good boxing. Bit of a mistake being on the ropes there, but he's replying with threes and fours.
Stay away from the ropes. Listen, he's going to come at you a little bit this round, just for a little bit, but he's blowing, mate. Stay with him, OK? Stay with him, man.
Stay focused. He's going to come
in.
Scrappy at times. This is when the referee brings about
the winner by a score of 19 points to 15 in the blue corner.
Shelby's won it.
Representing
he's got
Britain,
through.
Andrew
despite
Shelby.
Despite the warning, it's cost him a couple of points in the last round. Andrew Shelby
great
has gone through. They are probably just as relieved as they are pleased. Andrew Shelby will box a long time here in this tournament. But the important thing is the score. Even last run. Andrew Shelby. It was a bit too close for comfort, perhaps, but 4 points the difference. Andrew Selby from Great Britain is the winner.